welcome to our third video podcast. First of all, I would like to wish you a healthy, successful and inspiring year 2012. As you may know, we organize one of the largest design awards for students in the world, named IF Concept Design Award. So this time, we have asked professionals to give their best advice for young students regarding their future profession. Worldwide seen, we educate many million students in the world, and it is not at all easy to find an employment or set up your own studio after leaving school. So check the advices and see how valuable they are. See you next time. Bye.
First of all, I think they shouldn't stop within their profession. If they are somebody who wants to deal with print media, they shouldn't remain on print media. They should also look at the digital media and also product design. They should care about all disciplines of design, because I think nowadays we have to be have a much wider perspective than we had years before.
You can look for what you are interested in. What's your hobbies? What is your desire for this profession driven by? Hopefully not only by money, because it's very difficult nowadays.
If a packaging, if a design student wants to move into packaging design, he's better off moving to Germany, because you have more educations here actually. In the Netherlands, it's more and more coming to specialize in packaging design. I wasn't specialized in packaging design. I learned at Unilever, but I was trained as a designer, so the general principles of design also count for packaging.
My principle was always, I want to do a job that I love, that I have fun with, that I go for it, I can be passionate even before breakfast.
My advice would be to do a design education. See if you can specialize within in packaging design, and otherwise try to follow some elective courses, or maybe you can do elective courses in another country, because it is very interesting.
I think for students to gain their sort of autonomy as to creativity, they need to have a super big opportunity to touch and feel materials and understand them, because just like in the Bauhaus tradition, you really need to have materials to work with. Obviously, there are at least 50% of the formula of success, and the other 50, how successful is the design. The appropriateness of the material and the design mixed together make a perfect harmonious end product.
My first question would be about, what is your passion for this? Why do you want to make games? Because of big money, or because you're a gamer yourself, or you like the media combination of moving images, interaction and storytelling and audiovisual approach? Are you a musician? What do you know about all these disciplines that you have to bring together in a good game? I mean, or are you an engineer, a good programming guy who thinks very strategically in routines and thinking about complex structures? Are you, because programming is also about solving problems always and making them faster and compress stuff. So what is your really approach towards life? What makes you wake up every morning and when you say, okay, let's get up, I want to do this?
They also should try to know more about business processes and take the chance and not say, I am a designer, I have nothing to do with business. That's completely wrong, because when they don't understand the task, I can only do a good design if the task is clearly described. Then I can work, because we are task-oriented, we are not artists and work for ourselves. So, and to understand the task, I have to understand my client and how companies work.
I think if there is something missing, then there's a lack of communication skills between designers, marketing, and general business principles. There are very few designers who really understand the general business principles, and there are very few schools who are kind of approaching this lack in terms of, yeah, stay as a designer, keep your creative sources, your curiosity, your hunger for new things, but also at the same time learn more about the principles, because once you understand the principles, you can really better have a better impact on business. So somehow designers always are kind of schizophrenic, and they have to stay schizophrenic. Once they're losing this, this is the main source of power, or so main source of inspiration.
Well, one of my favorite designers, and he's really not a designer, is Ingo Maurer. Ingo Maurer does all these fantastic lamps or light installations, which have absolutely nothing to do with design. So if you are thinking of doing design, I would say just do it. You know, just do it for yourself. Convince yourself that's what you want to do. I think the education is important to a certain extent, but the education is the secondary. Yeah, do it for yourself. Do it because you want to do it. And I'm sure if you do it for yourself, you'd find your own market. Think about Ingo Maurer. Ingo Maurer studied graphic design, I think. He's not a designer, but right now he's one of the most respected designers around, for my money. Not because he's doing anything spectacular, but he's doing really the most basic, simple, intuitive products that everybody can relate to. So do it for yourself and convince yourself it's what you want to do, and just do it.